Okay, hi folks. Yeah, welcome back to our new session of operating system programming concepts. And here you guys will see the magic of Semaphore and the awk. Alright, so let's investigate about the use of Semaphore and the awk programming concepts that are like awk is some kind of utility for script management, like script manipulation, like string manipulation or something like this. And so what are semaphores then? Semaphore are synchronization primitives, is for synchronizing processes for critical reasons where the processes perform the task are limited, so they have to be shared among all the other processes, right? So for this, synchronization is very important, and this is done by semaphore. And the simplest semaphore is a variable that can take only value that is 0 and 1. So these are also called binary semaphores, having just two values, that is 0 and 1. So why do you use this weight system? Call it takes a parameter as a semaphore variable. If the semaphore variable inside the weight function is greater than 0, then decrement the semaphore variable. So you have to keep on waiting, that is, it is locked, the semaphore is locked. So if the semaphore value is like 10, it has to keep on decrementing 10 times, 10 seconds. Alright, so if semaphore variable is 0, suspend execution of the process. And that's it. So post is also something like, if some other, this function says that if some other process has been suspended, waiting for the semaphore variable makes it resume execution. If no process is suspended, waiting for the semaphore variable, implement semaphore variable. So how are semaphore system called used then? How are these things used? So these are used, and it has some kind of three important functions that you guys have to understand while using the semaphore system called, that are described here. Okay, let me go to the manual first, and I will show you. This is already here. I have. Okay, I'll show you again. First, let's clear the screen. Let's extend the terminal for viewer's description. And now, manual of init int semaphore init. What it does is initialize an unnamed semaphore. So here you initialize the semaphore, and the parameters are passed here. All right. So you guys can go through the documentation, initialize the unnamed semaphore as the address pointed to by this semaphore. So, and the value argument specifies the initial value of the semaphore. Okay, so initialize the value of the semaphore here, and pointed by this semaphore, initialize the semaphore. And also, locks the semaphore, right? As I told you guys here, it locks it. The semaphore value is, it's given 10 of 1. That means the semaphore is greater than 0. Then you have to decrement the semaphore variable. That means you have to unlock it. Actually, weight is just locking the semaphore variable by a process, and the process will just start execution. Alright, just guys go through the documentation by yourself. And like the third one, the third semaphore system called used is like in semaphore post, and just unlock the semaphore and implements unlock the semaphore pointed to by semaphore this pointer. So here's a particular example that I have listed here, and it's just initializing the unnamed semaphore, that is semaphore A, semaphore B here particularly, and here the value that is initialized is 1, and respectively here is 0, and you create the thread, and lastly you wait for the semaphore, that is you lock the semaphore, that is semaphore A, and sleep, you perform the action, and now you just unlock the semaphore, that is semaphore B. Now let's go to the investigate what is awk. So how do awk is a, I have already noted that awk is a language that is just specifically built to to perform like a scripting, if you have seen a scene scripting, it's a scripting utility tool for manipulating the strings. Alright, so how do you perform the explicit input with a get line in off? Guys, if you guys remember that I specifically noted that there are three kinds of input, okay, so to read the input from the in off, that is first was like from the command line, okay, from the standard input, that is from the keyboard or the pipe, and second was from the file, specifically you just notify the file, and third was, and third one is this one, this is called get line. And off language has a specific, like special built-in commands called get line that can be used to read input under your explicit control. So it is, you can read anywhere. Like you guys, if you check out the example here, I'm reading in a loop here. Okay, I do not have to explicitly just notify at the end. Okay, I'm just notify as a file, okay, as an argument pass. I can read anywhere I like. So this is the specialty here of getline, that you can, you have an explicit control of reading the file wherever you like, okay, inside a program, awk program. So getline returns 1 if it finds a record, and 0 if the end of the file is in concept. So just the basic concept is returning 1 or 0. 1 in case of it finds the record, 0 in case of it doesn't find any kind of record or goes to the end of the file. So if there are some errors in getting the record, then it's just going to like return -1. Alright, so guys, here I have just presented a simple example, and what it's doing is just, and my motivation was just to present you the use of this get line, having the explicit control of reading the get line. So here in the condition, it is just checking the condition that if the number of fields is equals to 0 or the first field is equals to some string, that is add on the string, like add include. And while this get line is greater than 0, that means 1, and if the record is found, then you just print such strings, otherwise you print such like random strings, right? And the basic concept is like get line is like function takes its input from the file, this file, it is like taking the input. So here the redirection is occurred, okay, like so the file is redirected and it is redirected to the variable. So what are patterns in awk then? Patterns in awk control the execution of rule. Okay. So a rule is executed when its pattern matches the current input record. So there are following kinds of patterns we will specifically deal for each pattern. Okay. In our following following investigation. Alright. So we'll investigate each and every kinds of patterns. So listing all the patterns, kinds of patterns they are. First is regular expression, second is expression, third is a range of expression, and part 1, part 2, and so fourth is a special pattern to supply or clean up information, that is begin or end. And lastly is an empty pattern, that is no pattern at all, it's a null pattern, which matches all kinds of pattern, that means it matches every input record. Alright, so what is a regular expression then? It's just a way to describe the classes of string, right? A regular expression in slashes is an awk pattern that matches every input record which takes belongs to that class. Alright, so regular expression is always quoted as such. As such means as inside, quoted inside of slashes. Okay. And how do we use this regular expression in comparison expression? Right? If you are going to use this kind of regular expression to compare, so what you do is you just define your regular expression, that is exp like slash with the slashes, including the slashes, you just define your regular expression, and within this bracket what you say is like if this expression that you have defined is not equal to this regular expression, then just you try to compare in this form. Alright, so this is true if the expression takes a character string, is not taken as a character string, this one is not matching by this regular expression. Alright, so here this expression that we have defined, if it do not matches, then it returns true. If it matches, then it returns false. Guys, okay, so some of the operators that you guys encounter in awk are, these are the operators, and there are like a bunch of operators you guys have to remember. So first one is the caret operator, so it just notifies the beginning of a string or the beginning of the line within the string. So beginning is started from caret, whereas dollar means it matches only the end of the string or the end of the line within the string. Alright, like the dot operator matches any single character except the new line. Alright, whereas if you guys have this kind of square bracket operator, which matches any one of the character that are enclosed in the square bracket, so any one of this can match. Whereas a pipe operator is used to specify the alternatives. And for rounded bracket, so it's used to concatenate regular expression containing the alternative operator pipe. So it's just used as a concatenate. Okay. Without alternative operator, that is a pipe. So also there is a star operator. The preceding regular expression is to be repeated as many times as possible to find a match. Alright, so you are just repeating multiple times. And we have a addition operator. The symbol is also similar to star operator, but the preceding expression must match at least once. Okay, so here this one is just to repeat multiple times and match. And for a what operator, the symbol is to also similar to star, but preceding expression can be matched once or not at all, just once or not at all. And a black space, a black slash, also we can say a black slash. This operator is used to suppress the special meaning of character. So all the special meaning of character will be suppressed by using such kind of black slash. Alright. Guys, it's okay, so comparison expression is also similar with the super meaning. So here you guys have to guys know by yourself, right? So what the special ones are, this one, these are called x tilde y or something like true if x matches the regular expression expressed by y, whereas x doesn't matches y, then it doesn't, then it turns true. Whereas also you guys have some boolean expressions, right? And also this can be used in as a operators for awk. So what are range of patterns then? So the range of patterns can, as I have, is a type of a pattern, and it is made by two patterns separated by a comma. So here first pattern that you specify is a big pattern, it's a beginning pattern, and second one is a end pattern, end pat, and this matches the range of consecutive input vocals. So the first pattern is big pat. What is it doing? Big pat, what is it doing? It's just like it controls where the range begins. Alright, and the end pat is where the control where the range ends. Alright guys, so an example. If you guys check out the example, what this example, this awk pattern is doing is like $1 equals to the B and $1 equals to E, so comma. So this is a big pattern, first one, and this is second pattern, like a end pattern, end pattern. So what it does, it prints every record that is between B or E pairs and inclusive, so also including, both of them included and between them. Okay, so another type of patterns is a begin and special patterns, and they are just used to match input records. Alright, they are used for supplying startup or cleanup information to the awk script. So startup and cleanup means something like before executing the awk code. Okay, awk code, what do you do? Okay, it's the start. What do you do in the start? And that is a big rule. Okay, the begin rule. That means whatever you should do before executing the awk program is all described in big rule. So if before the rest of the input record has to read, this big rule will be executed. And after the execution occurs, then the end rule will again start. Alright, so if you check out here, for the example, you see that beginning, before this awk script is executed, you just begin. And this begin rule is executed, so it just prints, count the number of line of file, and it just does execution, and lastly the end rule occurs and just prints the number of line. That is a incremental time. So what are arrays in awk? Arrays are also similar with C programming language, but there are some kind of fundamental difference. Alright, so what are the difference? One of the difference is that we do not have to specify the size of the array before we start to use it in awk. But in case of C programming language, we have to explicitly define the size of the array, right? And any number of strings in awk may be used as array index, because there is any number of index, as you can see here, array index. So each array is a collection, so any index 1 2 3 4 5, like it's not need to specify that you have this array index starts from 0. So each array is a collection of pairs. Okay, so this is one of the particular examples for giving you some hint about using array in awk. And this programming is just incrementing. Okay, looking through all the number of fields, then just go to the end. And just for each, all elements of the array, it just prints the word and the frequency. And that's array. That's implemented. Alright guys, so that's it for this session of awk programming language, and also a version of awk. So thanks for listening, and we'll continue in our next session. Alright.